Hachette Audio presents Great Americans in Sports, Blake Griffin. Written by Matt Christopher. Read by Alden Ford. This program includes a Mac and PC compatible PDF of bonus material. Introduction. It's difficult to tell how tall basketball players are from watching a televised game. When they're standing and playing next to each other, everyone on the court looks to be of normal height and weight. It isn't until the post-game interviews, when the players stand next to reporters, that it becomes clear that most NBA players tower above the rest of us like giants. And it's no wonder. The average height of an NBA player is 10 inches taller than that of the average American man, while the average weight of an NBA player is 60 pounds greater. These aren't statistics that are trending upward as the game becomes more modern. They have remained relatively consistent since 1980. Which is all to say that to be a contender in the NBA, it helps to be tall. Even in this land of giants, Blake Griffin stands out. At 6 feet 10 inches tall and with an incredibly powerful physique, he could easily be mistaken for a football player rather than an NBA All-Star. With one of the highest vertical jumps in the league, Blake's jump is even more impressive than his height. He's been winning slam dunk contests since he was in high school. Blake sees the floor like a guard and has become the most exciting young player in the NBA. Though everyone talks about his physical abilities, it is clear that his work ethic is what drives him to get better every year. Blake's work ethic is something he learned from his family as he grew up in Oklahoma. Chapter 1, 1989 to 2001, Growing Up in Oklahoma City. Looking at Blake Griffin now, he is hard to imagine as a child, because his size and stature make him seem larger than life. But before he was Blake Griffin, NBA star, he was Little Griffin, a skinny boy who just wanted to play. Blake Austin Griffin was born to Gail and Tommy Griffin on March 16, 1989. Tommy was a successful high school basketball coach in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Blake's older brother, Taylor, was born 3 years earlier and had been eagerly waiting for his baby brother's arrival. From the day that Blake was born, he and Taylor were each other's biggest fans. Like many brothers, Taylor and Blake were best friends, as well as rivals. Both boys were homeschooled by their mother until they were teenagers, so instead of getting time apart in different school classrooms during the day, they spent every minute together. That time together bred rivalry. Every game of horse and every board game played brought out the fierce competitive nature of the Griffin boys. They could turn just about anything into a contest. When Taylor started playing t-ball, Blake immediately wanted to play too. Tommy could tell both of his boys were talented, but he noticed something else in his younger son. Because Blake was always 3 years behind Taylor in terms of skill and athleticism, Blake had to work harder and learn to be tougher so that he could keep up. Taylor was playing t-ball, and Blake was 4 years old. We were winning, so Blake got a chance to hit the ball, Tommy remembered. The first time he hit it, he had a double. The second time, he had a triple. Every time he hit it, it went to the fence. He was only four. We started thinking, maybe there's a future there. Though they were homeschooled, Taylor and Blake were able to join many other social activities. Both showed a natural athletic ability at an early age, and they played on a variety of sports teams, including baseball, basketball, football, and soccer. The Griffins believed in letting their boys have a childhood at every possible opportunity, rather than forcing them to take sports too seriously. Tommy was careful not to push them toward a specific sport or to expect them to practice like they were players on his own high school basketball team. But being the sons of Tommy Griffin meant Blake and Taylor were around winning basketball teams their entire lives, and both boys picked up much of their work ethic from their father. Tommy was still a child when he learned many of the hard lessons he would later teach his athletes, students, and sons. When he was 10 years old, his father, Big Tommy Griffin, passed away, leaving his mother to raise Tommy, her only child, as a single parent. His entire neighborhood helped out by watching young Tommy. If he ever did anything wrong, his neighbors would say, "Hey, little Griffin, you don't need to do that." Tommy's neighborhood was more of a family, and his mother was always there for him too. Still, Life was sometimes tough for Tommy, and he looked toward role models outside of his household. One of those role models was his swimming coach, Roger Pierce. One day, Tommy would be a great athlete, but he encountered his share of rejection early on. In eighth grade, Tommy was cut from the basketball team and was very disappointed. Coach Pierce suggested that he try swimming instead. Tommy had never considered swimming, but Coach Pierce promised to teach him. 3 years later, Tommy was swimming at an all-American level. Being cut from the basketball team had taught Tommy an important lesson about perseverance. When one door closes, another opens. If he hadn't been cut from the basketball team, he might never have tried swimming, and never would have had the opportunity to swim at such a high level. After playing football and basketball at Northern Oklahoma Junior College, Tommy was a two-sport star at Northwestern Oklahoma State University in basketball and track. He graduated in 1970 with a degree in health and physical education, and he took his first job out of school as an assistant coach of the boys' basketball team at Classen High School. Tommy took over the head coaching position 4 years later, staying 15 years at Classen. Tommy won two state championships with Classen, one in 1975 and another in 1980. Unfortunately, the high school closed in 1985, leaving him without a job. The two championships looked great on his resume, but a job as a varsity head coach is hard to find, so he swallowed his pride and took an assistant position at the school he once attended, Douglas High School. Tommy decided he was going to do whatever it took to become a head coach again, even if that meant starting over at the bottom of the ladder. The Griffin family didn't see adversity as an obstacle. They saw it as an opportunity. Tommy's work ethic would later become a cornerstone of Blake's and Taylor's lives. If their father would willingly do whatever it took to get the job done, then they would do whatever it took as well. Gail and Tommy had met while working at Classen High School in the early 1980s, at a time when interracial marriages were still frowned upon in some places. Luckily for Afro-Haitian Tommy and Caucasian Gail, Classen was a very diverse school, and no one paid their relationship much attention. Periodically, the two would get strange looks, but Tommy and Gail learned to ignore these negative reactions. Looking past the color of people's skin, and not letting skin color define how they thought of themselves or others, were important values that Tommy and Gail would instill in their children. While Tommy spent his days teaching and coaching, Gail was in charge of homeschooling Taylor and Blake. The choice to homeschool the boys hadn't come lightly. When Taylor first went off to kindergarten, Gail realized that, as a former teacher, she wanted to have a bigger role in the education of her sons. She wanted to prepare Blake and Taylor to succeed academically and also to be good people. The Griffins taught the boys the importance of treating others the way they would like to be treated. The family gave when they could and helped others as often as possible. Sometimes that meant volunteering. Other times, it meant helping out a family with a meal. The Griffins didn't have much, but what they had, they shared. Tommy left his assistant job at Douglas when his first boss from Classen High, Coach Charles Davis, called with a unique opportunity. Davis was the head coach at John Marshall High School, and he was strongly considering retirement. He asked Tommy if he'd like to come to John Marshall as an assistant and take over once Davis retired. Tommy accepted and took over the head coaching position after only 1 year. He stayed at John Marshall for 12 years and coached teams to two more Oklahoma State championships in 1996 and 2000. The John Marshall basketball teams made a big impression on Blake and Taylor. The teams became examples of what it took to win a championship and would act as a blueprint for the Griffin brothers' successes later in life. Watching the John Marshall basketball team, Blake decided that he wanted to win every championship he could. Tommy spent years helping to shape the John Marshall students into young men, both on the court and in the classroom, so it is no wonder that he and Gail raised two amazing young men of their own. Even before their four magical seasons at Oklahoma Christian School, everyone knew that with their physical strength, strong characters, and determination, Blake and Taylor were going to be something very special. Chapter 2, 2002 to 2005, Back-to-Back Brothers. After Tommy guided John Marshall to a 2000 Oklahoma State Championship, and despite having a great team...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.